How did your parents like react when you told them? Like?
I think at the start they were maybe not so supportive because they didn't really understand what I was trying to do. In their mind, they thought, why not just go back to be a lawyer and then with all the money that you earn, you can just donate, right? Like what most people do. But I tried to explain to them that, I mean, I've already worked there for 1 year. I know what's going on. I know that donations do come. No one is addressing the problem of the need for livelihoods, you know? People give free medical, free legal help, but people just need a job. Then they can buy their own medical and they don't have to feel like they're always begging for something. So hopefully, I think they understand that a bit more now. It's not just about giving handout, it's about giving them like the dignity of work lah. Hi, I'm Madeline. I'm 28 years old and I'm the owner of Mad Roaster. Back in 2019, I was a pro bono lawyer for refugees in Thailand. And we helped them fight their legal case. So at the end of the case, when we win, they'll ask me like, oh, what happens now? How does my life change? Can I have get a job now? Can I earn money to support my family now? So I decided that I needed to move into livelihoods to find a way to give them work so that they can sustain their family on their own. So I had a friend in Thailand who ran a project that takes the ethnic embroidery or like the artwork also and tries to sell it as it is. The hardest part for him was to find demand because not a lot of people will buy like an ethnic bag. And even if they buy it once in maybe a few months for as a present, they don't buy it every day. Before I went to Thailand to be a refugee lawyer, I used to work in the CBD as well, actually at Raffles Place. When I was thinking of something that could sell in high volume to create as much work as possible for the refugees, I straight away thought of coffee because of how highly consumed it is here in Singapore, especially in the CBD. So to open this shop, I had to first go and learn how to make coffee, learn how to appreciate it, really like start from scratch. So what I did was I went around to various cafes in Bangkok and then I just asked them like, can I work for free? And actually surprisingly, no one even wants me to work for free because in Bangkok the labor is so cheap, plus the person they pay can speak Thai, which is obviously better. And I'm like, I cannot speak Thai at all. When we first started, we knew that we had to have a toast option, but for me personally, I don't really like to eat bread. I always thought like, oh my god, bread is so plain and dry, but that's why if I had to make a bread, the only bread I will make is brioche because it's so much butter, it's sugar, and then for us we have all these fillings, right? Like cinnamon filling, chocolate filling. So by the time you eat it, it's almost like a dessert. That's why I'm like, okay, like this bread I can eat. So this is the only bread that I would sell. I wouldn't sell plain bread because I actually don't like plain bread. We know that we are still in a hawker setting, so we don't want to push our consumers too far from like traditional kopi to straight away that very like floral, acidic notes that you get at hipster coffee joints, right? So every cup you buy will be the same signature blend. And it features like Ethiopian sidamo, which we chose because this is more of an in-between. It's a more heavier, full-bodied blend. Through this, like every cup of coffee that someone buys, we get to commission them to do art for our packaging. These are the stickers that we get from the refugees in Thailand. As you can see, like every cup is different lah. And then at the back, we write a bit about the specific refugee that colored that sticker that you see on your cup. For each sticker that where we commission the artwork on, it's we pay them around Singapore 50 cents for each sticker. And we try to commission enough stickers per month such that it can at least cover their rent. We want them to be able to feel like I'm covered, every month I'm covered. Not like this month, I don't know when my rent is going to come, am I going to be evicted? So it's a very stable sort of income for them. A refugee actually came by to our shop, so he's a former refugee. He used to be a refugee, but now he is like probably a PR or something in Singapore. He figured out his legal status and he came by and he said like, oh, he read about our shop. As a refugee himself, he knows what it's like when you move to a new country. So he wanted to thank us kind of for doing this and he gave us 50 bucks and asked us to pay it forward for other customers to come to our shop. That's how we started the pay it forward scheme. So at the start, before the shop took off a bit more, I was able to, for example, set up and then when there's a lull period, like before lunch or in between breakfast time, I will take out my computer and just sit here and do my law. And then I just like drafting stuff, drafting advice. But then when the traffic picked up, it became a bit harder for me because I always need to be in there pulling shots, which is why now I've had to get some staff to help me. We have a lot of different kind of staff. So some of them, they actually come to us looking for a job, like the normal process, and that's our barista now. Whereas some of them came because they read our article and then they said like, oh, they want to volunteer to work for free because they really like the cause that we are supporting. Obviously when he came, I was like, no, like we'll pay you for your time, for your work. But it's very nice to know that there are people out there who are willing to just like help. So daily I will wake up around 6. I will like pack everything that I need and bring it all to the shop. Then by around 8, that's when my staff comes. And so we open the shop around 8. And then around maybe 9 or 10, that's when I have to go and start preparing the bread for the next day. Because it's CBD and then you know COVID now. So especially at the start of this year when it was raining very heavily, we realized that there was really zero sales. And then we had to innovate as a hawker center. You can't just rely on physical people who walk past. So recently we just launched this toast set, or like toast box set. Basically it's our cinnamon brioche and our chocolate brioche, 4 slices of each, and then a bit of custard and crumble. Because if you eat the chocolate by the slice at our shop, what we actually do is we put custard and then we put salted chocolate crumble, and a lot of people like it that way somehow. And it also comes with 4 bottles of cold brew. So it's really like perfect for if you want to have breakfast for your whole family, it's all settled there. If you're in the area, you want a good cup of coffee or you want some bread, right, for your breakfast, can consider trying our shop, because not only are you going to get your bread or toast, which you already want, right, but you are really helping someone, and that little bit of help actually goes a very long way. Yeah, and you can just do it with your breakfast. You're helping someone every day with breakfast.